Okay, we are here near the marina where our boat is getting ready for us. Right here, somewhere, we don't know where. And we are at the Le Boat office.
Very cold. It is raining. It is sunny and raining, but I hope we will be okay. We have a lot of luggage, like we are going for a week, for a month, not for a week, but it is what we have to have. So we are waiting for the boat. It's our boat, Horizon One. Вот такая вот лодочка. Now we need to have a briefing. We can go up. If it is warm, you can steer here, up here, and sit and tan here. But apparently we are not going to do it. It is too cold. It is a gray day. Gray, not great. Gray day, gray and cold.
It is our boat inside. We have stove, microwave, refrigerator, and even the TV. You can steer from here, from inside, if it is cold, if you decide to steer from inside. And we are getting right now instruction about everything. It is the bathroom. Looks good with shower. The boat is relatively new, 3-4 years old, and so it looks good. It looks sparkly, actually. We like it. It has a lot of space, and two people can sleep here, and a lot of storage, by the way.
I need to close it.
And two people can sleep here. Actually, it's very roomy, and the salon is big as well. We like it. The instruction was over about 4 o'clock. We did little drive around. The wind was really strong, and it rained on and off, and it was too late to go somewhere. We decided to spend the night on the base, and next morning, it was calm, but cold.
We are leaving the dock. Ben's driving. And there are swans. They are swimming.
Of course, we are not going all the way down to Portumna. We just going to Dromod. It is 15 miles, approximately 15 miles, and approximately 3 hours. But originally we wanted to go earlier, one day earlier, and stop in Jamestown. We stopped there on our way to Dromod just for a short time. It is a very interesting place, you will see.
Goodbye. We would never come back, I think, right? Of course, never say never. We will see. Do you need my help?
I need your watch. Especially if I go under this bridge.
cloudy. It was sunny actually earlier in the morning, but now it is cloudy again. And cold, my love. The red buoy is on the right, the green buoy is on the left. You have to keep between, otherwise it won't be good. Started our journey on the Shannon River. We will see how it is going to be, but my fingers are freezing. I'm cold. You see, when we were in France riding a boat on canal, taking a boat on the canal, it was different. We could moor anywhere we want.
And you also didn't really have to worry about the channel because the canal was narrow and the boat did not need very much water, and you could go pretty much anywhere in the channel, and then you could even pull over the side, and because it was flat bottom, you could just tie up on the bank wherever it was. These boats and this river are not like that. You have to stay in the channel, but otherwise you will run aground, and the boat requires several feet of water. So, and the shores are rocky, so you can't just tie up wherever you want. You will run aground and be stuck.
They look cold too. My feet are getting cold.
We saw many fishermen along the river and heard many shots. We did not understand at first what it is, but then people explained to us that it is the hunting season right now, and yes, people are hunting for, yes, ducks on swamps and in the forest. We made a mistake. Instead of going to the left, we did not look to the left actually. We went straight where we are not supposed to go. And I hope we don't have a big problem. Now we have to carefully turn.
Now that buoy right there, is it red or green?
Yes. If you look at the map, you can, yes, tell that the navigation channel is very narrow in some places. And it is very important to keep your boat between markers. So the, yes, binocular was very, yes, useful in this case. Some markers you can see very well.
We need to stay away from this red buoy, our description says. But look at beautiful swans. I saw many swans here. Okay, do you see the red buoy?
I do, and the green.
And the green one, great.
I do.
You are a great driver, I am a great navigator. We are a great team, right?
The swans are better.
It is very peaceful here, very great view. Somebody put like fishing trap, probably.
Now you see the next green or red? Where are you gonna get one?
We decided to not.
Closed.
We decided to not go to our next destination where we are going to spend the night. We are going to Jamestown. It is here. At least we will try.
Honey, put your camera down.
Our instructor said that it is tricky to dock here.
Put your camera down.
We will see. Jamestown. And we are going to try to dock. Cold. You see, we made a little mistake. No, how little? In our case, it is little. It is a private dock. And we docked here. We were in a hurry because the current is very strong here and we wanted to dock. But actually the public dock is on the other side, you see it? And the bridge, you can't go through under the bridge. Not just maybe clearance and strong currents and shallow places behind the bridge. After you leave the bridge, you can't go there. You see? End of navigation. And like I said, it is Jamestown. Why I said we made a mistake? We can't get out from private dock because there is a house and everything is locked. So we are locked out, but it's okay. We just wanted to go inside. Ben drank some coffee, I got some tea, so we can get warm a little bit because we were really cold. But it's a small place. Let's see it from the drone. We are leaving Jamestown. It is warmer a little bit, not too much, but it was a nice stop. We warmed up. Now we are on our way to Dromod. We are not going to stop anywhere and we need to go through one lock still. We will see how it will go. In France, it was stressful. We don't know how it will be here. I guess if you want to stop for the night
in
Jamestown, yes, it is a better place to stop. Just turn to the right from Jamestown, and it is a bird docking place, and it is public, and we stopped on private. And then you go under the bridge. It is the better place. Very convenient and not so stressful, right?
Yeah, this will not be a bad place to stay, actually.
We did not know it. We will know next time, if there will be next time. Approaching the lock, and we see the green light. Apparently, it is good for us. We will try to get in the lock. It is our first lock.
Can you hear me?
Uh-huh. Yes, it seems like we are going to be on the right. About 3 years ago, we took a canal boat in France on the Canal de Midi. We went through probably 20 locks, approximately. And locks were different. The experience was completely different than here on the Shannon River boating. We did not have any help, so if only 2 people are on the boat, it is very difficult to manage these locks. You see, the worker is getting the line from the boat and putting it on the ballast, and he is helping you. There, on the Canal de Midi, we did not have any help, so you are managed by yourself, and I jumped up and down from the boat in order to manage it. It was actually not really easy, especially when we had a staircase with 9 locks at once. It was insane, but we managed. And here, but there is another difference. The Shannon River doesn't have too many places where you can dock. When you can just stop your boat on the Canal de Midi, you can stop your boat anywhere. It is safe. There are no rocks on near the shore. On the Shannon River banks, we were told that it is better to not do it. And actually, we should not do it at all. We should dock only in the proper place where it is safe to do it. So, we are passing the lock. It was a piece of cake. Our first lock is done. It was easy, not like in France, not even close. The water is not high up or down, probably 22 meters. There is another boat with cold people. They are wearing life jackets. Maybe it's a good idea, but we are keeping near us the life jackets. Driving when sitting on the pillow, because the cushion is icy cold.
Isn't this great fun?
What did you say?
I said, isn't this great fun?
Yes, after
after this, our cruise, 26 days cruise, will be like a paradise.
Well, I don't know, if it's this cold, I won't get off the ship.
I think you said everything after this trip will be a paradise.
I think so. Don't go river cruising in Ireland in October.
Period.
During all this time from Carrick on Shannon to Drummond, we met only two boats. And people looked so cold on that boats. Cold like we are.
Yep.
We are approaching Drummond. In this place we are going to spend our night. Next night will be here. It took 3.5 hours approximately to drive from Carrick on Shannon to Drummond. Many boats are here. We are surprised.
It seems like they have a lot of empty space to dock, and we were really happy about this.
We docked. What is the name of this place, my love?
Drummond.
We docked in Drummond. This place is almost empty. Nobody wants to take a boat on the river when it is cold. But we are here. Nice little houses. Of course, it's not tourist area. This house is for sale. Who wants it? Ben is cold, as usual. Look at this house. Isn't it nice?
Three birds of them.
Uh-huh. And look at the fence.
Uh-huh. Yeah, somebody lives look over here.
Very interesting fence. Very nice street.
People here have nice houses.
Yes, very nice houses.
A little dog house or whatever it is.
Uh-huh. Yes, it's true. They have nice houses.
And I'm wondering who lives in this little house.
This little town has just one restaurant, right?
Well, one or maybe two. It seems like from the sign back there, maybe they have two.
Look, apparently they have a famous football team.
You're not serious.
No, I'm serious. This car.
The vehicle is a Morris.
Morris Company. Jason, Irish whiskey. Apparently it is the main street of Dromot.
See all the signs over there?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go over there and see where everything is.
Let's go. He has probably Irish whiskey and he's drinking it.
Coal miner.
Yes, coal miner.
There's a big mine, there used to be a mine around here. Coal miner.
Dromot Lodge. You can stay here probably. Yes, it is a hotel, and a very nice one, probably. Apparently, this was a town well in 1870, only well in this town. Everybody got water here. There is a fountain in this square, and three interesting birds.
Look at this beautiful fountain.
You can see three birds like this, not only in the square. We tried to figure out what it means for Dromot. Honestly, we couldn't find any information about this. We talked to locals in Dromot, and they said that the housing is very expensive in this particular place. Many Irish people have like a second home here.
Again, we are cold, but look at these beautiful flowers. They are not afraid of cold.
We are approaching the train station. Probably you notice that it is very clean here too. No parking anytime, and the mailbox, yay! Let me look at the train station. We actually passed this place on our way from Dublin to Carrick-on-Shannon. Very clean, very nice place, and very small waiting area. Here you can wait for the train. Pub. The copper still. It's another restaurant. And there is a little grocery store. Let's see what they have. You can get birthday card here.
You know what's funny?
What?
We came here for entertainment. We don't even need anything.
Uh-huh. Actually, it is a big store. Even bigger than Spar.
You can spend the night there.
Huh?
You can spend the night there.
Where? Here?
Right here at this restaurant and guest house.
Oh, yes. It is a restaurant and a guest house. This means you can spend a night here.
Luxury accommodations.
And there are even a few stores, little stores, I think. Health and fitness center. No, not stores, just small restaurants. It is raining, 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 but we are here in the boat for the night. And we will see you tomorrow. You can tell, you can hear the wind. It was a rough night. The wind was very strong and rained all night. In our next video, we will show you what happened in the morning.